In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us offer this Mass for our intentions and for the intentions of the people whom we promise to pray for. And also, let us ask the Lord for the blessings for this day. And so to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask for God's mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who filled the priest and martyr Saint Maximilian Kolbe with a burning love for the Immaculate Virgin Mary, and with zeal of souls and love of neighbor, graciously grant through his intercession that striving for your glory, by eagerly serving others, we may be confirmed, even until death, to your Son who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord cried loud for me to hear, "Come, you scourges of the city." With that I saw six men coming from the direction of the upper gate, which faces the north, each with the destroying weapon in his hand. In their midst was a man dressed in linen, with the writer's case at his waist. They entered and stood beside the bronze altar. Then he called to the man dressed in linen, with the writer's case at his waist, saying to him, "Pass through the city, through Jerusalem, and mark a tau on the foreheads of those who moan and groan over all the abominations that are practiced within it." To the others I heard the Lord say, "Pass through the city after him and strike. Do not look on them with pity nor show any mercy. Old men, youths and maidens, women and children, wipe them out. But do not touch any mark with a tau. Begin at my sanctuary." So they began with the men, the elders who were in front of the temple. "Defile the temple," he said to them, "and fill the courts with a slain. Then go out and strike in the city." Then the glory of the Lord left the threshold of the temple and rested upon the cherubim. Those lifted their wings and I saw them rise from the earth, the wheels rising along with them. They stood at the entrance of the eastern gate of the Lord's house, and the glory of the God of Israel was up above them. Then the cherubim lifted their wings, and the wheels went along with them, while up above them was the glory of the God of Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is His glory.
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The glory of the Lord is higher than the skies. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen. I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, amen. I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by the Heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyo, mga kapatid. Reconciliation and forgiveness ay isa sa mga struggles ng marami sa atin. And madalas sa pagpapatawad, dito tayo halos nahihirapan. Kasi ang iniisip natin lagi ay yung sakit at kumakapit tayo sa mga hirap na pinagdaanan natin dahil sa bigat at sakit na naramdaman nang tayo ay minsang ma-offend or masaktan ng ating kapwa. But then, sinabi sa atin sa Ebanghelyo na sa pagpapatawad ay kailangan magkaroon ng malalim na usapan between you and the offender. Pero madalas, aayaw natin makikipag-usap at aayaw din natin makikinig. Ang gusto natin ay maramdaman nila kung ano yung naramdaman. But then, sa pagpapatawad, it requires first humility. Hindi naman kailangan lagi na yung nakagawa ng kasalanan ang hihingi ng tawad. Pero kung tayo, victim, ay magpapakumbaba din para kausapin yung tao na ka-offend sa atin. Kasi most of the time, minsan akala ng nakasakit sa atin, hindi tayo nasaktan. Akala nila okay lang. Pero minsan hindi din natin nai-express ng tama yung ating emotions, yung ating feelings. And humility ay magbibigay ng lakas ng loob sa atin para makipag-usap. Anyway, sabi nga din ng mga matatanda, walang hindi nadadaan sa mabuting usapan. Madalas sa panahon natin ngayon, pag tayo ay nasaktan or na-offend, ang ginagawa natin, hindi natin kinakausap yung taong nakasakit sa atin. Hinihintay natin sila mag-approach. And worse, nagre-recruit tayo ng taong magagalit sa kanya. Mag-play-play victim tayo sa sitwasyon. Pero again mga kapatid, sabi sa Ebanghelyo, kausapin in private ng sarilinan. Pag hindi kinaya, magdala ka ng isa o dalawang tao na hindi papanig sa'yo, kundi magbabalanse ng usapan na meron kayo. Maipapaunawa sa taong nakasakit sa'yo kung papaano ka nasaktan at maipaunawa sa'yo kung papaano ka dapat magkakaroon ng lakas ng loob para magpatawad. Hindi yung tipong tayo ay nagre-recruit or naghahanap ng taong kakampi sa atin para i-condemn yung taong nakapanakit. Again, ang pangalo pong hinihingi and sa pagpapatawad, it requires sa pusong maunawain. Kasi kung walang pangunawa ang lahat, iisipin na lang natin kung paano tayo nasaktan na dapat nilang pagbayaran. Pero sa pagpapatawad po, unawaan ang kailangan upang maintindihan ang both side. Upang maintindihan at maipaunawa mo ang iyong nararamdaman at maunawaan mo kung saan din siya nagagaling. Kasi may mga pagkakataon na ang tao ay nakapananakit dahil may pinagdadaanan. Pero hindi po to justification sa mga nararamdaman nila para manakit. Pero hindi, minsan hindi nagkakaunawaan, kaya mas lumalalim ang hidwaan. And pangatlo, sinasabi na kung hindi kaya ng pangalawang step ang pakikipag-usap, go to the church, call other peoples, and let pray for them. Kung hindi kaya maging sa simbahan na makapagbigay ng kapatawaran sa pakikipag-usap, then treat him as gentle and tax collector. Pero again, nakita natin kung paano si Kristo ay trinato or nakitungo sa mga gentil at mga tax collector with mercy. At yun pa rin po ang pangatlong hinihingi sa atin ng Panginoon. Kung sakali mang hindi na maging mabuti ang relasyon ng mga taong nasaktan at nakapanakit, magkaroon pa rin tayo ng pusong mahabagin para sa mga naka-offend. Ipagdasal natin, hindi na kailangang ipamalita pa kung paano ka nasaktan. Hindi na kailangang ipamalita kung paano naging ganun kasama ang tao. Pero kailangan nating maging magkaroon ng mahabaging puso para sa kanila. Dahil hindi nila alam kung paano hihingi ng kapatawaran at hindi nila alam kung paano aalisin ang bigat sa kalooban nila. Pero sa atin, napakahalaga na pangalagaan natin ang ating peace of mind, ang ating mga sarili mula sa mga bigat na dala ng hindi pagpapatawad. Again mga kapatid, sa buhay natin, maraming pagkakataon na tayo ay muling masasaktan at paulit-ulit na masasaktan at mahihirapan. Pero taglayin po na sana natin ang pusong mapagpakumbaba na kayang humarap sa lahat ng sitwasyon na kasama ang Diyos. At pusong maunawain na kayang intindihin ang mga pangyayari sa buhay. At higit sa lahat, pusong mahabagin katulad ng sa Panginoon na kayang tingnan ang kabutihan ng kapwa kahit sa pinakamahirap na sitwasyon ng buhay. Amen.
Please stand.
Jesus, tell us today, if two of you agree to ask something, it will be granted to you by my Father in heaven. So we pray together and say, may your presence fill us, Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
That the members of the church may be drawn close together, living in peace and harmony. Let us pray to the Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
That leaders of nations may respect the rights of every person and avoid repression and atrocities. Let us pray to the Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
That we may have the courage to speak the truth with love and accept criticisms graciously. Let us pray to the Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
That the sick, the aged, and the housebound may see God's comfort and consolation in the compassion of those who care for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
That the dead may be cleansed and prepared for eternal unity with Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
May your presence fill us, Lord.
Heavenly Father, with your Son in our midst, we ask you to help us believe in the goodness of each person and be patient with one another as you have been good to us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
We present our oblation to you, O Lord, humbly praying that we may learn from the example of Saint Maximilian to offer our very lives to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of the blessed martyr Maximilian poured out, Christ, to glorify your name, Show forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness, through Christ our Lord. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Maximilian, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that renewed by the body and blood of your Son, we may be inflamed with the same fire of charity that Saint Maximilian received from this holy banquet, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,